Knowledge check one. A study assigns four schools to intervention and comparison conditions. Schools A and C implement a new reading curriculum. Schools B and D continue to use the same reading curriculum they had been using. Then, during the study, a new principal hired at School C refuses to allow the researchers to collect post-test data. The analytic sample includes schools A, B, and D. Is there a confounding factor? The correct answer is A. Yes, there is an N equals 1 confounding factor because there is only one intervention school in the analytic sample. The study started with four schools, but after school C dropped out, the study was left with three schools, including only one school in the intervention group, school A. This is considered a confounding factor because the study cannot distinguish the effect of the new curriculum from the effect of attending school A. For example, students in school A might participate in a whole school reform that includes additional silent reading time, or the teachers in school A might receive more professional development on reading instruction than those in the other schools. In this example, it is impossible to determine how much of any observed difference between the intervention and comparison groups was due to the intervention and how much was due to other features of the particular school that used the intervention. Knowledge check two. Half of the math teachers in a school implement a new supplemental math curriculum. Four of the five teachers implementing the new curriculum have master's degrees. One of the five teachers in the comparison group has a master's degree. The other teachers in this group have only bachelor's degrees. Is there a confounding factor? The correct answer is B, no. There is no confounding factor related to teacher education because the teacher's education does not align completely with only one group. In the example, there is at least one teacher in each group with a master's degree, and there is at least one teacher in each group without a master's degree. Knowledge check three. Ms. Johnson's fourth period math class receives a new intervention, and her fifth period math class receives the regular district curriculum. Is there a confounding factor? Yes or no? The correct answer is A. Yes, there is a confounding factor since there is a single class in each condition. This is an example of an N equals 1 confounding factor. It's impossible to separate the effects of the intervention from any other effects of the particular class in the intervention group, such as classroom composition or peer effects that could influence outcomes. What is the highest rating the study can receive? The correct answer is C. The highest rating the study can receive is does not meet WWC group design standards because we cannot attribute measures of the intervention's effectiveness solely to the intervention. Because the study has a confounding factor, it cannot receive any other rating. Any other design features that might affect the study rating, such as randomization or attrition, are irrelevant when a confounding factor is present. Knowledge check four. A study examined the effects of a pullout intervention on reading scores. Students in the intervention group met with the reading specialist who delivered the intervention for 30 minutes each day for 6 weeks. The comparison group students continued with their regular reading activities. Is there a confounding factor in this study? The correct answer is A. There is a confounding factor. Only one group met with the reading specialist. Any differences between the outcomes of students who used the intervention and those who did not may be due to the intervention, the reading specialist, or both. Knowledge check five. Five teachers in an elementary school volunteered to participate in a study that examined the effectiveness of a new math curriculum. At the beginning of the school year, three of the teachers implemented the new math curriculum. Two of the three teachers implementing the intervention had master's degrees, and the rest of the teachers had only undergraduate degrees. Is there a confounding factor in this study? The correct answer is B. No, there is no confounding factor. The study uses volunteers, but the WWC does not consider volunteering to be a confounding factor. There are no factors that align completely with either condition. Although all teachers in the comparison group had undergraduate degrees only, this was also true for one teacher in the intervention group. This concludes our review of confounding factors, Module 4 of the WWC's Group Design Standards Training. Let's review what we learned in this module. We reviewed the WWC's definition of a confounding factor. We also discussed several different examples of confounding factors, as well as examples of things that are not confounding factors. We also learned how the WWC considers studies that test combined interventions and how confounding and non-confounding factors affect a study's WWC group design standards rating. Next in the training series, we will discuss outcome measures in Module 5. Just a few final reminders. You can access all the resources mentioned in this module through the WWC website, whatworks.ed.gov. Please note that the full slide deck for this module is available on the WWC website. This includes detailed responses to the knowledge check questions. To receive a certificate of completion for viewing these training modules, you must view the videos on the WWC website. Thank you for viewing the Confounding Factors module.